Can you say binge?
Binge.
Can you say watchers?
Watchers.
Welcome to Binge Watchers, where we talk about the stories and characters we love and the shows they live in. My name is Ron, and let's talk about season one of the Apple original, Mythic Quest, Raven's Banquet. Mythic Quest is brought to us by some of the same folks who gave us It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, and it focuses around a game studio, specifically one developing an MMO called Mythic Quest. This is essentially, you know, World of Warcraft, Elder Scrolls Online, all those types of games all rolled into one. And it obviously takes a lot of jabs at Ubisoft, the game publisher, since the executive overlords are always referred to as Montreal, where Ubisoft is headquartered. Ubisoft, interestingly enough, is actually one of the companies that helped produce this show and contributed a lot of game footage and other assets to the show. Which I find really interesting. If you've ever watched a video from Jim Sterling, you know that Ubisoft doesn't exactly have the best image as far as game publishers go, and this show really doesn't pull any punches making fun of the things that are wrong with the video game industry. So I guess it's cool that Ubisoft helped make a thing that makes fun of them? I guess. So the story itself focuses on the people running the studio. Ian, the creative director, Poppy, the lead engineer, Brad, head of monetization, and David, the executive producer. All of them have been working together for a good long while. All of them have pretty much driven each other crazy. And they're all these wonderful exaggerations of the character tropes that they inhabit. Ian is the visionary creative behind the game. He's incredibly dramatic. He has this whole insecure alpha male thing going on. But he really does care about the game more than anything. I'm actually not going to start analyzing every character in the show, but I am going to say that something that this show does extremely well in a very short amount of time is establish exactly what each character's thing is, what's their driving force and main personality trait, crank that up to a million and pretty much make them clinically insane, but at the same time make them feel fleshed out enough to be just incredibly engaging, like you end up caring about a lot of them. I loved every single second of this show. I got the Apple TV trial just to watch this show, so I still haven't paid any money for the subscription, but if I had, it would have been worth it. This show understands the things that it's making fun of so well. The reason I never found a show like Big Bang Theory, for example, funny is because I never felt it understood any of the things that it made fun of. I wanted to like it because on the surface, it's a show that makes fun of much of the geek culture stuff that I love. But it's really more of a show for people who know other people that are into this stuff and they don't really get it themselves, but they just want to make fun of those other people, which is absolutely fine. But for me, it meant that I never found it funny. Shows like Silicon Valley or Community, for example, are shows that are much more brutal in the way that they make fun of stuff. But because they clearly understand the things that they're mocking, it's just so much better, so much funnier. An example for Community is either of the D&D episodes. They were clearly written by someone who plays D&D and knew to make it accessible enough and funny for people who don't play, but endlessly hilarious for people who do. In Silicon Valley, if you ever worked at a startup, then just yes to everything in that show. So for me, Mythic Quest is now up there with those shows in terms of understanding your subject matter. You don't have to be a hardcore MMO player to enjoy this show. It's funny on its own right without any prerequisites. But if you are a little familiar with the gaming industry, you'll find a lot of just delicious little gems in this show. That doesn't make any sense. You don't eat gems, but you know what I mean? This show is really good. One of my favorite things about this show is that while sometimes it uses a traditional story structure for an episode, it never really lets you have those feel-good character growth moments that sitcoms tend to really, really like. Like, you know how I Met Your Mother at some point just stopped being funny because it became a drama, and I personally stopped watching it then because it wasn't good enough to be a drama that I'd be interested in, and it wasn't funny anymore, so it wasn't what I came to that show for. So it really feels like Mythic Quest takes all of those moments, recognizes them, and then makes sure to always undercut them with a moment that says, no, this person was an asshole and they're still an asshole, and that did not change just because they had one good moment. And I love that. And at the core of this show, there are interesting stories. If you watched my review for Upload, the Prime Video show from Greg Daniels, who also worked on The Office, you know that I thought it was fine, but not great, because it felt like a really cool setting with good characters, but a very generic and predictable plot. So there simply wasn't enough for me there to hold the whole thing together. Mythic Quest is first and foremost a comedy, super subjective like anything else, you know, but I thought it was really, really funny. The characters are pretty incredible because each one of them is just an over-the-top representation of their type of person and the role that they play within the studio. And at the core, the story is actually interesting. And there's even this beautiful standalone episode that shows you the complete life cycle of a video game and video game company from inception to demise. And it's amazing because it's a completely standalone story with new characters. And it's more engaging than many hour-long episodes of proper dramas. It shows you just how much talent there is behind this show. And also that episode has Jake Johnson, who I love dearly. And I can't help but mention how good Danny Pudi is in this show. I haven't seen him in anything really since he was Abed in Community, and I don't know if this was on purpose, if this is what he was going for, but in Mythic Quest, he plays the anti-Abed. He plays a guy named Brad who is responsible for all the loot crates and other mechanisms in the game designed to, you know, suck players dry and take all their money. He's the aggressive corporate suit bro who just cares about money. It's as far away you could possibly get from Abed while still remaining within the realm of geeky things. But in any case, he nails it. He's incredible in that role. And honestly, everybody else in this show is as well. Bottom line, should you watch it? Yes, absolutely. If you're into gaming at all, then it's a no-brainer. But even if you're not, I think this show is strong enough and funny enough for you to enjoy it regardless. And there's also a really interesting documentary on Netflix called Playing Hard, which chronicles the making of a game called For Honor. And it's interesting because it can show you a lot of the real-world equivalents to the folks that you see on the show. And it's actually the same game that Mythic Quest shows, for most of the season at least, on screen as Mythic Quest, which is, I just thought that was really interesting. Anyway, I thought this show was fantastic, definitely worth getting at least the Apple TV trial for. It's a 7-day free trial, and the show currently only has 9 episodes that are 20 to 30 minutes long, so you'll get through it pretty fast. And the benefit of me losing half the video and audio for this video, so I had to reshoot a lot of it again, is that in the meantime, I got to watch the 10th episode that they put out. They put a quarantine episode that is shot with everybody working from home, and it's brilliant. It's brilliant. It's like, it's one of the best things that I've seen on TV. I smiled for like the whole day after watching it. It's so good. And also I forgot to say, Binge Watchers certified awesome. This show is incredible and I love it. I love it with all my heart. What about you? Have you watched Mythic Quest? I really want to know your thoughts. Let me know in the comments down below. And if you're going to be talking about spoilers, you can't really spoil anything in this show, but if you are going to be talking about spoilers, use spoiler tags in your comments. And if you're finding Binge Watchers for the first time, welcome. I'd like to invite you to join the Binge Watchers community. Come talk about TV with us. It's a lot of fun. Subscribe to the channel or join the Discord. But in any case, keep binging and I'll see you next time. Can you say, can you say binge?
Binge.
Can you say watchers?
Watchers.
Hello, I'm Julie, actually it's on tape.